Fishy, 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 fishy. Hey everyone, Raleigh here, and welcome to another episode of Ark Scorched Earth here on the Molten Iron server. Today, we're going to start off by mating these two wolves up behind us. We finally got ourselves two decently high level ones, so it's about time for us to make some babies to make a second pack for us. So that's what we're working on today to start off. So let's get these guys unfollow. That'll keep them from going too, like they won't go any wandering or anything while we're doing this. And then this is Sylvanas, right? All right, so I'm going to have them unfollow. And then I have to do a whole bunch of you to tell them to stop. So I'm sorry for the whistling. We'll get this started, and then I will bring you back once she is ready to go. Almost there. Come on. Get pregnant. And bam. There we go, guys. Okay, guys, we're almost there. It's time for a baby wolf pup. Are you ready? What do we got? Come on. Come on. Baby pine. Oh, look at this little guy. Alright, let's get some meat on there. Came out as a 164, so it looks like 1518 for health. 832 is going to be its stamina, or weighs 241, 283 for melee, and 130 for movement speed. So, we're going to see. Wants care in 20 minutes. So, yeah, I'm going to just kind of hang out here. Let's get your wandering turned off. And it is a little baby male. Look at these. He's all white, too. Like, white, white. Are you all white? Look at you. You're all white, too. I didn't even realize that. Come on, buddy. Come on over here. Let's turn down your follow distance here, shall we? Come here, little buddy. Look at this little guy. Yeah. Oh, who's a good boy? Who's a good boy? Your yellow eyes are kind of look a little crazy-eyed. Like your eyes are looking in two different directions. You guys see that? All right, buddy. We'll be back. Oh, what are you doing? You eating? Okay. Let's give you some more food. Alright, guys. I'll bring you back when it's time for the first care. Okay, guys. Welcome back. We're 36 seconds away. But I decided I had to change the name here. So, oops. We're going to call him Side-Eye. He's just got that kind of that googly eye look to him. You know what I'm saying? Like, look at that. He's just not looking right at us or anything. Alright, 16 seconds. Let's see what this guy wants. Okay, please don't be something I can't do. I had to be kibble. Oh, sweet. Let's go for a walk, buddy. Yay! 41%, that's good. Who's a good boy? Who's a good boy? Yeah, it's you, Side-Eye. Come on back, let's go back over here. Can you get back over here? You get stuck on the raptor butt? Yeah, that happens to the best of us. Okay, guys, about 10 seconds left here. Side-Eye is now an adolescent. Let's see what he's gonna want this time, and how many percentage points we can get. What do you got, buddy? What do you need? Oh, yeah. I love that you want to go for a walk. Let's do this, buddy. Come on. What, you figured out how to walk? There we go. Oh, psh. That's it. It's all it took, huh? Ooh, I do not know if we're going to get another one of these in, guys. Oh, I think time's against us. I don't know if we got 20 minutes on this. Alright, well, we're gonna find out. We'll wait and we'll see. Otherwise, we'll at least get 88% imprinted. 82% imprinted. I take that back. And we'll see how that goes. Back in a few. So guys, we are almost there, and we are gonna miss. The last timer is not gonna let us get to it. 9 minutes, and we have just a little tiny sliver left. So, looks like we got some server settings to adjust to see if we can get this to work at the full 100%. But we did get 82%, so not too bad. Yep. So side eye is almost there. Yeah, it's almost done. Let's just pull that out there. Yeah, there you go, buddy. All right. Full grown side eye. Let's take a look here. So 1767, stamina is 832, weight's 241, melee is 283, movement's 130. And just to make sure. Yeah, nothing changed when we get on there. Just want to make sure. Alright, so there we go. We got ourselves another decently high level wolf. Not the crazy highest, but now we've got three relatively high level wolves to kind of go with the rest of our guys. So, sweet. Let's get side eye in here. Oh, so I think I showed you guys that Whitman had logged off over here. He apparently had some connection issues. And he had to log off rather suddenly. So I thought I'd leave him a fun little present that when he wakes up, he'll be surrounded. Because my dinosaurs are keeping him safe. Yeah, safe is what they're doing. Keeping him safe. Alright, so I'm going to put Brophy back here, and then we will move on to the next thing, guys. Back in a few. Welcome back, guys. So we're going to take the pack, and we're going to go to the Red Obelisk. We are going to leave these guys over here for a little bit, because UTC has been sick. And while he's been kind of out of commission, his dinos have been dying. So we need to give him a little bit of protection, I think, over there at Red Obelisk until he's back and ready to go. So we're going to take these guys over and put them on loan for a little bit. Since you guys have been with me after we bred up Side-Eye, I actually found a level 120 male and tamed it real quick. And I adjusted a couple settings for the server to see if we get a higher imprint when we do the breeding. So since then, I've bred another wolf up as well. So we actually have a pack of pretty decently high level wolves now. So I figure we might as well take these guys over and put them on loan for a little bit. Now this pack that we've been hunting the deathworms with, this will be the pack that we actually leave up there, up in the north. We'll leave these guys up in the north to work on just deathworms. So once UTC is good to go, if he needs to keep a couple of these guys, he can. But other than that, we're going to leave these guys up north. So I'm going to head over there real quick once we get over to the Red Obelisk. Oh, actually, we're pretty close. So yeah, once I get some stuff set up for these guys, I will bring you guys back and show you what we're doing. All right, guys, we have the middle of a lightning storm, but we got some stuff spiked in the rest of the way for him, put a gate up. I'm going to leave the pack over here, like I said, so we can try to keep him safe until he's able to log back in. Hopefully that'll be pretty soon. But I just noticed something too. Look over there. Do you guys see all those fish? We got to try fishing in here, man. So we're going to take this guy with us because he is on neutral for us. He's also on follow, so at least I know he's not going to just run away on us. We're going to try fishing. I know it's, like I said, it's kind of loud because it's a storm and stuff, but I mean, there's just way too many fish not to try this out, right? So I'm going to leave this guy right behind us here. And then I actually just happened to have the stuff on me this time because I thought maybe we'd be able to do this here. So let's get some leech blood on there. Let's grab a seat. Alright. It's been a while since I've done this, so this will be a little tricky probably, but see if we get some cool blueprints or something like that, because like we've noticed that you don't really see blueprints for weapons and stuff on here. It seems like those only drop from like alphas is what we've been reading about, so I'm just kind of wondering if we're going to get better blueprints or any blueprints actually off of the fish here, so we're going to try that. We'll see what's happening. Okay. E-A-A-S. Nothing. Okay, well. Let's try this again.
Fishy, 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 fishy. DTC. No, wrong button. Boo.
So I don't know if you guys have ever seen this, but the fish on Scorched Earth do some weird stuff, and they apparently picked that one spot that they're all gonna be in right now. So we just threw the lure over there. Some wild Carno raging over there, but we've got the pack wolf right next to us, so we should be okay there. But I just thought it was pretty funny. They just kind of all just hang out in one little spot there. Okay, here we go. A, D, Z, X, C, D, D. So, yeah, we got a lot of stuff, but we didn't get any blueprints. I'm just trying to see if we can get blueprints from doing this. And so far, the answer has been no. And this is what we call the metal run, guys. So we are gathering up a bunch of mats here, because Cryo has graciously offered to craft up some stuff for us, so I am going to spend the next hour or so probably gathering up as all the materials I can, because we are going to try to get ourselves a couple things made here. So I will bring you guys back once we have some things. Welcome back, guys. So it took a little while, but Cryo and I just finished making the stuff for the industrial cooker and the chemistry bench that are going to be at our base now. So that's all done, and I thought I would bring him a bit of a payment. Cryo did talk about how he was looking for a high-level wolf. So this is the perfect tame I had yesterday. So I'm going to bring it to him, because I already have a mating pair anyway, so I don't actually need to have another one. If it was a female, I would keep it, because our female is not a high-level, or not a perfect tame, but this guy is a 120 that we found and prime-tamed him. So he is good to go. So I'm going, well, not perfect, it's 179, I guess, but... So we're just going to drop him here. We're going to land right here. And then see where to go. Where'd the wolf go? There he is. And we'll just bring him in here for Cryo. If we could... Okay. Zatrix is here too. He is helping Cryo right now with the raising of his new lightning, of Cryo's new lightning drake, wyvern. So this is the one he's going to raise to be a community attacker. It's 148, so it's going to be crazy. Look at this melee damage, 251 already. It's great. We did change some of the imprinting stuff that, I mean, obviously you guys saw what we were playing with earlier, trying to get everything set up. So this is actually the first wyvern that has been hatched since we started doing that. So hopefully this one can get 100% imprinting. We'll see how that goes. But yeah, so we're going to say goodbye to you, little buddy. Such a brief time you were in our company with us, but you know, we need to pay some stuff back, because let me tell you, not only could we not have gotten to the chemistry table and the industrial cooker for quite some time still, now we don't have to spend the Ingrams to learn it, because we already have it. So, I mean, that's awesome. That's just a little bit of Ingram points we can use towards something crazy and fun. So, alright, we're going to go back to the base, and we are going to get everything rolling to get everything placed. So, I'll bring you guys back once we are ready to start placing stuff, and it's going to be awesome. Welcome back, guys. We are getting ready to place the pipe for the industrial cooker. Now, right now, we're just trying to line this up so it's as straight as it can be. This is very rough to do, obviously. But I think we're pretty good. It doesn't look like there's much movement side to side from here. It's a little bit, but not too much. Now, the thing is that the industrial cooker has a weird snap point. So I'm going to try to just... I mean, we're doing stone pine because it doesn't really matter at this point. So if we come all the way out, it's too far, right? So I'm gonna try, you can see just the tip of the pipe is just outside the wall right now. So I'm just going to kind of put it in a little bit there. And before I can place it, because if I place it here, it's going to snap too far down. I'm just, without moving the mouse, I'm going to put the foundation in place. and then press the button again for the pipe. And now the pipe should be in the spot we want it. My bad. Oh God. Oh jeez. Follow all. Oh man. All right, let me clean up this mess. Okay, welcome back, guys. Everything's back where it's supposed to be. And I did have to take this down because it was actually, the cross section was actually putting the thing off center. Because it's, for some reason, the cooking pot isn't actually built on center. So you can see if we look right at the thing, we had to go a little to the left just to get it to kind of line up like we wanted to. So now we're going to place this in there. We need to put one of these guys down. And then, can I place another one of these? I certainly can. Okay. We want to do, not an incline, a straight one. We'll just drop this on the inclined one. I'll probably end up using that now. Actually, now that I think about it, I will probably want that. So, hold on. Alright, and then we should just be able to put in another one of the... Oh, is it obstructed because of... this must have obstructed it. Huh, crap. Is this going to destroy my... Nope, okay, perfect. So... Oh, it's obstructed because of the... I didn't even know you could obstruct it with this. Okay, well, I guess we'll have to make another one of these. And then we have another snap point out there. Okay. So, let's make another one of those. Do I have the materials I need in here or not? That is the next question. Pipes, metal... I need some more metal. I think I left some over here. Certainly did. Just bring some of that over. Way more than I needed to. I meant to split that stack. I don't know why that's so funny, but it is. Okay, let's put the metal in here. We are doing structures and pipes and metal and one of these guys. And then we're going to need... let's just take the rest of these guys. We'll put this here. Go down and get this. Alright. Now we should be good to put one there. And then one out. One out here. There we go. And now, let me put that there. I thought that I did. Didn't I just do this after I had put that piece in? Alright, well, we're gonna have to do this again. I'll bring you guys back in a minute. Okay, I got that figured out, guys. Let me show you. So, I had to place the pipes, then the foundations, and then I could put the water tanks on there. So that was just me not doing things the way that was supposed to, because I'm not always the brightest bulb in the box. So that's good to go. We'll have to either wait until it rains, or we'll forcibly fill them with hydro over there and kind of get that working. But before we go any farther, then let's go ahead and go over here, and now you'll see industrial cook pot. Now if we go over here, it should be pretty lined up with the wall. Yeah, not bad at all. Look at this, guys. We've got an industrial cooker. That is awesome. I can't even tell you guys how much I love having these industrial cookers. Making dye, making kibbles if we make kibbles, pretty much everything else is just super easy now. Oh, that's awesome. Okay, so while we're doing this, we've got our outlet box here. Let's go ahead and place that right there. And then we can place our chemistry bench next. Okay, let's see. So, I'm gonna get this as straight as we can. Let's see here. What are those guys doing? Let me just see if these guys are trying to... They're trying to raise that wyvern. I think they need milk. I'm gonna see if the Tapahara might help them out. So I'll be right back, guys. So that was a false alarm. By the time I got over there, and I left as soon as they said they might want to try to tackle that tonight, They were trying to get, they're raising that lightning wyvern that we looked at, and they were trying to get some extra milk for it. By the time I got there, though, which is really close, it was already ready to mature out, so it was already done. So, no big deal. All right, so here we go, guys. Time for the chemistry bench. This is the piece de resistance. Let's get close in here. Let's actually go to third person. Crouch down. That crouch down is what takes it off the ceiling. So if you, by the way, if you guys didn't know that, if you don't crouch and you can't see it all of a sudden, it's because it's actually above us. It's up there right now. So when we crouch down, it brings it back down to this floor. Now we can press K and we can see how close we are to flush. Oh, okay, so we need to turn a little bit this way. That may have been too much. That looks pretty good, actually. Let me just. Oh, so it can't be too straight if we're able to obstruct it just by going to one side. So, like that. And then how are we looking on this wall? That looks pretty good. Alright, guys, look at that. Yeah, all right, we got our chemistry bench too. This is gonna make things so much easier. Because, like, I went up and made clay the other day at the forge. Look at this. Bam. Full. And it only took, guys, it only took, like, 10 minutes to get a full 4,500 of those things. So it's crazy how much faster that is. So now I got that. We're good to go. To be honest, the mortar and pestles, we can just get rid of them, but we're gonna keep them there because I think it looks pretty cool over there. Now, there's one more thing I want to do. I realized that when I placed this the other day, it didn't make any sense. I shouldn't have put that generator in the corner like I did, because like if you look at this now, if you look at the balance here, right? We've got the cooking pot, and then we've got an empty space in the wall, and then we've got our chemistry bench, right? And then over here, we've got the fabricator, and then bleh, we've got the generator. So we're moving it. So I made another generator. We're gonna put it on this side. I thought that we had a way that it was like almost full. Yeah, that's fine, whatever. Okay, so that's on the same line. We're gonna take all of this. Oops, take all of this. We're gonna place it all in here. Turn this one on. And we're going to just actually before we do that, let's just shut it off. Everything's still running. Yep, okay. Just want to make sure. And we're gonna demolish this. Goodbye. Alright, so now a little more balanced out. I might move the fabricator over at this point, to kind of help us match up on what we have on the other side. Yeah, I think we're moving over so it kind of matches what's over here. Do I even have the stuff to do another fabricator right now? Structures, crafting, spark powder, crystal, and oil. Do I have crystal over here? Oil isn't a problem. I don't have any crystal. And I don't think I have it any place weird either. Consumables? Do I have any crystal over with the flint and stuff? No. Okay, we got one more place to try. Let's check Clayton. If Clayton's got the crystal we need, we're just gonna make a new fab right now. Let's see. What do you got in here? Any crystal? No crystal. No crystal. Just some random stuff all over the place. We have to clean some of this up. No crystal. Ah, ha, ha, ha. Okay. Perfect. So let's go back inside now. Thanks for breaking my fall, guys. I appreciate that. Okay, so we've got the crystal. Let's go get some spark powder. Oh, this is gonna be great, guys. All right, let's put that in here. Structures, crafting. Oh, oil, right. I totally knew that. And oil. Oh, okay, my bad. Get our oil in here and crafting. Make a new fabricator. Bam, okay. Now, I'll go over here and hopefully this isn't gonna.
Overburden me? Nope, good. Demolish. Now we'll get this one lined up on this wall. No, okay, so we should just be centered on this wall, right? Yeah, it looks like it. Okay, and then we'll bring this. Let's try to line it up on this line down here first, and then we'll go side view in a second here. Okay, blip, blip. Get that side view going. Oh yeah, we're way off. Oh, that's pretty good, I think. Okay, now let's go. Yeah, look at that. It's perfect. The best thing ever. Alright, I didn't go through the wall, did I? I hate when that happens. No. Oh, alright, perfect. Alright guys, so there we go. Bam, I'll put all that stuff back in a second, but look. So, generator. Then we've got our AC units over here. Then we've got our fabricator, our storage. We got our little smithy and forge section here. The mortar and pestles, which are kind of useless now. Let's see, and then, oh, wrong button. And then if we go over here, chemistry table, industrial cooker. Guys, we are all set. We're all set now. We got everything we need inside this base. We don't have to do the crazy thing with the forges because we've got the forge that, you know, the big forge that everyone uses. But look at those. We are awesome. Okay, so we got one more thing I meant to do. And remember when I said that incline pipe and I thought I was ridiculous for keeping that incline? I'm going to show you what we use it for now. So now if we do the incline, is that going down? It's going the wrong way, isn't it? Oh, I can't do what I was going to show you. Okay, well, I guess that's not going to happen. Usually, I would put an incline here, and it would come out towards us, and then we'd put the water tap on, but it looks like the incline's taking it outside, so I guess that was pointless. All right, guys, I think that's it. We did a lot of crazy stuff this episode. We tamed up the wolf. We did some breeding, and we played with some of that. We took some stuff over to UTC to try to keep him safe. We went up to the forge and had Cryo help us, but look at this. We came out of this with a crazy cool industrial cooker. We've got ourselves our chemistry table, moved our fabricator, moved the generator, and everything looks so much better now. The base is looking so much better now. So I hope you guys have had a good time. If you have, of course, you could drop a like below. You can always subscribe for more content, and don't forget to check the link below to see all of the other YouTubers that are actually on Molten Iron. There's a lot of good guys that are doing a lot of good stuff on there. So yeah, I'll catch you guys on the flip side.